Amir, there was a shrine about a giant lady with lots of books and visions.
Ah, that would be Gloa, the knowledge keeper. She was a gifted sorceress who gathered every tome of arcane wisdom she could find in the realms, all in the hopes of augmenting her powers of prophecy that she might find her lost husband, Arvandil. But it was not her husband she would glimpse in her visions, for it was Gloa, seeing longer and farther than any before or since, who witnessed Ragnarok, the end and the beginning.
You what?
Tell this one later.
Guys, part of his crew? That's a tough crew.
And all were his responsibility.
That's a lot of responsibility.
Does it frighten you? Responsibility.
No. I don't think so. I mean, I think it used to, but not as much anymore.
Why is that?
Well, being out here with you makes me feel more grown up.
Here. Boy.
Sir. Okay. That's going in the journal.
Thank you.
should probably do this because I can't get back onto the, I'm on the rope. That was pointless. Oh. It's very far away. Okay. gonna go to the other side and get that tracking thing down. Yep. You go ahead and do your thing, I'll do mine. Be more sensible to put it here. Fuck me.
A wolverine.
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Again? A wolver? Fuck. Now, guess I gotta kill one of you fuckers eventually.
That looked like it hurt!
Do not worry about me.
Don't die. Now I literally have no health. Ah, I see. So there's a rune chest nearby. No shit.
Oh, we probably shouldn't.
Come on, give me health.
Considered a tackle retreat.
Sweet as health. Haven't I been here? I think I have.
He had their loyalty, so they followed.
And then they all died. He must have been a bad leader.
Why do you think that?
He led all these men to their deaths.
True. These men chose to follow. Even if they make poor choices, the best take responsibility for them. Remember this.
Ah. Holy shit. Oh, sure, I was gonna die.
It's over. It is over, isn't it?
Leader?
I... Yes, led men in battle.
Good leader?
It is complicated.
Did you ever...
Nobleton's boy. Full task at hand.
Yes, sir.
Right then, where were
we? Ah, yes. Roa the Knowledge Keeper, without her husband and vision, but instead discovered Ragnarok. When Odin caught word of her Ulsi, he maneuvered to obtain it and hoard it for himself. Groa, new long-time patron of her services, and so she welcomed him in the library as a friend. What she did not know is Odin himself was behind her husband's disappearance. He used his enchantments to conceal death at Thor's hand from her sight. Smiling, jealous, and took her by the throat, and with his very hands he stole her library and her life for his own.
I always knew Odin was bad. That is...
ruthless? Heartless? That's Odin. In fact, we would do well to sit here in silence for the next few moments and reflect on Odin's capacity for cruelty. And so...
reflect longer.
There.
Fuck me! Stop it!
That was the last ship. I hope the captain will be satisfied now.
Unlikely. He was determined to put these men to rest himself.
But he would have never been able to.
That does not matter to him. Our victory will only remind him of his failure.
Then, why do we do this?
You gentlemen certainly know how to get. Why don't you? All this began with Boulder.
He just knocked on our door.
Boulder just knocked on your door.
He just showed up and started a fuck. He said he wanted to know something. He said, I know.
Oh, well, we'll circle back to that later. Exactly did he want to know?
I was under the floor by then.
He said I already knew what he wanted. Perhaps he mistook me for another.
Eh, that's quite interesting.
Oh, there. Got another favor to ask you two.
What do you want, Dwarf?
Got another lead on my Anvari. Meet me at the Lawnsoother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain at the mines. The ones is just south of the river pass. Now you two want something, or you just gonna stay gag-scrapped and slack-jawed? Pull the ring off on Vari's hand, your minds. Always tampering with souls and dark matters of the night, see? Just the sound of his hammer flattening over.
Take a look at this.
What you got for old Brock? See, you boys ran afoul of some travelers. Or them travelers ran afoul of you, more like.
Who are they? What do they want?
Dunno. Oh, you ask a lot of questions. So what'd you find out there?
Father, why did you really want to help the spirit?
You need the...
I've had plenty of it against fighting these things. It's the real reason.
This man inspired loyalty. He took responsibility for his mistakes, and he was determined to... He's a good lesson.
Oh.
Yes. Oh.
My men are... They're no longer.
That's right. We killed... We laid them all to rest.
I see. So even in death, I am a failure.
But in life, you were honorable, strong-willed, inspired loyalty. These are good qualities. Aren't they, boy?
Yeah. How many men followed you here?
I... Thank you for your kind words. May your journey have a more pleasant end, then.
Well, you're right. You didn't seem very satisfied. I guess you never really get over losing ones you care about.
Never.
I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Ganungagap, the Great Age. There were no realms yet, only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced...
water?
More than water. The mythic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. From Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. He called himself All-Father as if he was the creator and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant.
Ymir?
Huh? Oh, sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
Looky who decided to show. Talk to this here Reen.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brock. It's talking to me! It's Unvarin!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake, but then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff? Anvari had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools. And one beaut of a hammer. He make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Anvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your Inch Stone.
Anvari isn't happy about us taking his stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that.
Ah!
too long. Anvari says this dwarf was part of his crew, that he died because of his mistakes. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
Did not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. It cannot be trusted.
Damn it. Can't be that simple.